Today's topic and discussion will be all about this guy, one of the biggest stars of the silent film era, Mr. Buster Keaton.
Welcome everyone, Adam the Woo here. And even though most of the locations from those very famous scenes that were shot nearly 100 years ago do not exist anymore, there are a small portion that do still exist. And I'd like to show you where they are, right here, off Hollywood Boulevard. It's my second channel, Daily Vlog Channel. It's the Daily Woo.
This was his stomping grounds, at least the ones he wanted to hold up over time on screen, right here on the corner of Quahanga Boulevard, right down there.
In fact, sometimes when he didn't want to use a back lot or studio, he filmed a majority on this little stretch of road right here.
In the 1925 movie Go West, this parking lot is prominently displayed where he walked a cow up right past the light pole that used to exist here. Naturally, over time, they have replaced it with a newer one and added this restaurant. But if you watch that scene, the side of this building and the building right over there. An interesting clue, look at the back wall. There are two windows, one between those two poles above the man's head and another one here a little lower down above the cars. Now tell me, do those look familiar to you? Those are the same exact windows. One here and the other right here at the back side of the parking lot. The building across the street used to be a fire station that was shown in many different productions. And take a look at this little alley to the left. That was used in a scene where he hid underneath a police car and got away scot-free. From the spot I'm currently standing, take a gander at that building in the background. It still remains right over there. That's the same parking lot where he had the cow. Obviously, there used to be storage units that are now apartments, and they've changed a little bit as far as adding more windows, but it's the same structure. Same cannot be said for the former fire station that has been removed and replaced with this building. But right over here is where he slid on his head, almost upside down. I don't know how he didn't injure himself more than he did. Right about here, give or take a few feet. Man, that's painful.
He used the spot on another occasion as he's riding on the back of a fire truck past these buildings that can be seen behind me. And once again, that parking lot prominently displayed, and he rides the fire truck into the fire station, which used to be right here. He's on the fire engine moving down the road, camera mounted on the back. You can see his face prominently, and then shuk-a-kung, indoors he went. Arguably one of Keaton's finest moments happened right in front of this very alley where he latched his arm onto the back of a moving vehicle. They have a curb now, and the building on the left is the one from way back then, but the one on the right has been extended over and replaced, and now there's a restaurant down in there. This was considerably wider at the time. But how amazing is it to think that so many years ago, all the action happened right in here. Pre-planning, preparing yourself, having all the extras behind you ready to chase you. And then your moment to shine. You dart down the alley. You stand in the proper place. The car comes by, you grab it, and off you are whisked. I'm standing in the middle of the road now, just real quick while there is no traffic for a moment. There it is, that's the shot. Incredible. Silent movie history, right here. If you zoom way in towards the back of the alley, you will notice a building under construction way back then. And look at the little emblems on the top of the windows. Well, I'm happy to say, those emblems still remain right up there. All these years later, located, you just walk to the back of where that scene was shot.
I always love this classic one where he's on the horse and carriage. He tries to make the turn, sticks his hand out, and that dog on the flatbed chomps into his fingers. Look at the buildings in the background. This is where it happened. In fact, the buildings still look the same other than being converted into apartments
adding more doors and windows.
In fact, look at the trim directly above the bay door behind that old vehicle.
That trim is still up there. Granted, they have widened some of the passageways, but that's that old bay door, and that's the trim. It's amazing something that was created nearly a century ago with no talking, very little music, and very little cards describing on what was going on. The action set and described in each scene told the story more than music, more than vocalization. It's still just as funny now as it probably was back then, or it was 50 years ago, 40 years ago, 30 years ago. It stands the test of time. There is one more spot located here on the corner of Hollywood and Vine. In fact, it's a precursor to the scene earlier where he was on the back of the fire engine and he made his way a couple blocks down the road into that former fire station. He runs right out in the middle of the intersection, jumps on the back of the moving vehicle. In fact, you can see that building there with the archway door in the shot. Runs right along here, grabs hold, and off he goes down Hollywood Boulevard. Needless to say, I was pretty freaking excited when I discovered that all this stuff is right here in my neck of the woods, in my neighborhood, just right around the corner. Pretty awesome. A few years ago, I was given this book. It was written by a gentleman by the name of John Bingston, and he has written a series of these based on different silent film stars and the locations, all in California, not just Southern California. And he was a big help. This book generated my interest and sparked the idea and the inspiration for me to do this video. So I'm gonna give him a quick little shout out. His book is named Silent Echoes, Discovering Early Hollywood Through the Films of Buster Keaton. I don't know if it's still available for purchase, but quick Google search and you could probably figure it out. Once again, his name is John Bingston. Pretty amazing guy. He did his type of Columbo-like research skills. Oh yeah, this guy has a passion. I think him and I would be pretty good friends. Vlog over.